Next up, we have Dr. Al Sensor, who's going to talk about a petition that he has.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'm Willie Alden, so I'm a retired physician, and yes, I am from Greenville, and I'm not as eloquent as the gentleman that spoke before me. When I heard about the closure of the hospital yesterday, I scratched my head because I see the need of this place for this population here in this area, having had the opportunity to consult here a few times and then having had the need for their services, me and my wife, several times. So I had the idea of sending the Vidant folks a brief letter and thought maybe that would have a little bit more weight if I put it in form of a resolution and have a few folks here. I was hoping to have a good crowd, but this is even a better crowd than I thought it was going to be. Have a few folks here sign it, and unfortunately I only have two copies, but I put them down there on the big stone slab, and if you'd be so kind after the meeting to come by there and put your name and signature on there, I would appreciate that. Yes, I will do that momentarily. The resolution is to keep Vidant Pango District Hospital or like facility in continuous operation and further improve its services and especially address the needs of the ever larger aging population of Eastern Beaufort County. Whereas Beaufort County ranks poorly in state and nationwide county health ranking, and whereas Beaufort County is one of the poorest counties in North Carolina, and whereas within Beaufort County, its eastern parts, of which Belhaven is the center, is an especially underserved area, and whereas no scheduled public transportation is available in Beaufort County to carry people to Washington or Greenville to medical services, and whereas the population of Eastern County has a disproportionately large number of elderly and minority people, and whereas the eastern parts of Beaufort County are relatively undeveloped and do not have the internal resources to address the underlying issues which have resulted in poor healthcare rankings. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the owners of Vidant Pango Hospital consider the importance of Vidant Pango District Hospital to the healthcare of people living in the eastern parts of Beaufort County and Hyde County, and further consider the economic impact on the community of a closure of Vidant Pango District Hospital, and that all opportunities be explored to improve the healthcare for the people of Eastern Beaufort and Hyde County while specifically addressing the needs of the region's aging population and make this into a center of excellence for community-based living and care for elderly people. And I thank you for the opportunity to speak to you.
As you've heard from our speakers, this all comes down to money. And healthcare is a place where sometimes there needs to be some government involvement. And this is the kind of situation where the government needs to make sure that people are not left out in the cold. And this is what's going on, being left out in the cold. So I would urge every one of you to try and make some contact with Vidant Health and let them know that you're not happy. And we will try in the newspaper different things to let you know different ways to let them know our feelings. But we have all got to be proactive. We have got to talk to our friends and neighbors. And we might need to have another rally to show them that we're not dying away. Because I can tell you how politics works. What they know is that in 6 weeks, nobody will hardly remember this. You won't remember it until it affects you. It'll just go away. And that's the way it works. It's just like in presidential politics. They know that. In just a short period of time, people forget. You don't even remember what the top story was 6 weeks ago. Now all you can think about is Syria. But with this hospital issue, we've got to keep it in their mind that we're not happy. And we have to come back right here sometime in the near future and have another rally and talk about what they've done to that point. We need to have another community meeting. Because if they know that this is not the last thing they're going to hear, they don't want this going on again. They don't want all these news cameras around again. If they know we're coming back, they're going to want to talk to us. If they think we're going to go away, they're going to just let us go away. So I implore you that the next time we have one of these meetings, and it may be in the next couple of weeks, I want you to come back with more people. And then they will have a problem that they will have to deal with. But we have to stay vigilant. And when you come back, bring two people with you. And keep, we're going to have to keep it up until we succeed. It takes some determination to overcome things like this. Once again, we can't do anything to make Biden do anything except we can expose what they're doing. And shame will sooner or later catch up with them and make them come to the town and talk with us and try to work something out that we all can agree with. We know they've got problems with the hospital. All of us know that. All of us don't expect anything extreme, but we do expect to be talked to, and we do expect to have input, and we do expect a certain level of care in Belhaven. So with those words, I'm going to close the rally. I want to thank every one of you for being a patriot for Belhaven and coming out. And once again, when you see these signs and banners go up next time, come out and bring two friends. Thank you all very much. Got all excited. I'm gonna get in trouble with not only Pastor Amos Wilson, but the Lord. Hold on. We gotta do the benediction. Go on, Pastor Wilson. We need his prayers.
Thank you, God bless you. We have heard what's going on, and it's really gonna affect all of us. My children were born in that hospital. CJ was born right down there in that hospital. And I told him, and he said, "Oh my God." So it's just going to affect people in Englehart, Swan Quarter, Scranton, all the surrounding area. It's going to affect all of us to have to try to readjust. So if we can do anything, we know that prayer works. I know prayer works. So I encourage each and every one, pray that God would touch those leaders' heart. Amen. Because the hearts, God has the heart of every man in his hands. He can turn it any way he wants. So we're going to pray. And you promised me that you will pray that they will have a change of heart, a change of mind. We're going to be dismissed by, let us pray. Father God, we thank you for everything that our ears have heard, our seen. Father, we thank you because it's in your hands, Lord. We ask you for your help. Now, Lord, as we leave, let everyone don't fail to pray, because you said man ought to always to pray and not to faint. Don't let us faint beside the way, but help us to be continuously in prayer. Now, as we leave this place, Lord, let us never leave your presence and keep us under your precious blood. But we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. You dismissed. God bless you.